Tamil Nadu is a beautiful Indian state mostly popular for pilgrimage sites, historic buildings and hill stations. On our channel, we have previously uploaded one tour package of Tamil Nadu. Here is our second tour plan of this state. In this tour package, we will go to Chidambaram, Pichavaram, Thanjavur, Trichy, Rameshwaram and Madurai. Day 1. On day 1, reach Chennai either by train or air from any part of the country. From there, go to Chidambaram by car. Chidambaram is 216.9 km away from Chennai and it will take almost 5 hours to reach Chidambaram from Chennai via East Coast Road. Upon reaching Chidambaram, go to visit Nataraj Temple. Nataraj Temple is the main temple of Chidambaram, which is dedicated to the Nataraj or the dancing posture of Lord Shiva. This temple is located in the heart of the town and has undergone numerous renovations under the reign of Chola and Pallav kings. Day 2. On day 2, go to visit Pichavaram Backwater. Pichavaram Backwaters is a popular picnic spot, which is around 16 km from the center of Chidambaram. The 11,000 hectares of backwater is set against a backdrop of 3,000 acres of mangrove forests. This is an ideal place for boating and water sports. Boating charge here is Rs. 25 per person per hour. You can also enjoy backwater cruises and spend time in the houseboats. Day 3. On day 3, go to Thanjavur from Chidambaram. Distance is 109.4 km via National Highway 36 and National Highway 81. And it will take around 3 hours to reach Thanjavur from Chidambaram. Upon reaching Thanjavur, go for local sightseeing. Main places to visit are Brahadeshwara Temple. The Brahadeshwara Temple is commonly popular as the big temple. Built during the reign of the great Chola Emperor Rajaraja Chol, this temple is an architectural marvel. Gangaikonda Cholapuram. This is a place which is testimony to the architectural and engineering genius of the region. Gangaikonda Cholapuram is a place worth exploring. The magnificence of the Brihadeshwara temple along with few others will thrill you with its history as well as engineering. Vijayanagar Fort. This famous tourist spot is located nearly 2 km from Brihadeshwara temple. This majestic fort was built by Nayakas and partly by Maratha rulers during the early 1550. Day 4. On day 4, go to Tiruchirappalli from Thanjavur via National Highway 83. The distance is 59 km and it will take almost an hour to reach there. Upon reaching Trichy, go to visit local sites. Main places to explore are Rockford Ganpati Temple. The most popular place in all of Trichy is the Rockford Ganpati Temple. It derives its name from its unique building style. The temple structure comprises a huge rock which is believed to be the oldest rock in the world, older than the Himalayan mountains. Kallanai Dam. 15 km away from Tiruchirappalli, the Kallanai Dam is built across the river Kaveri. Vekkali Amman Temple. This is another famous temple of Trichy. Sri Ranganatha Swami Temple. Sri Ranganatha Swami Temple is situated in Srirangam town of Trichy, Tamil Nadu. This is a Hindu temple dedicated to Lord Ranganatha, a reclining form of Lord Vishnu, and covers a total area of 156 acres. Day 5. On 5th day, early in the morning, go to Madurai from Tiruchirappalli. The distance of Madurai from Tiruchirappalli is 138.2 km via National Highway 38 and it will take around 2.5 hours to reach Madurai from Tiruchirappalli. Upon reaching Madurai, first check into your hotel. After that, visit famous Meenakshi Temple. The historic Meenakshi Amman temple is located on the southern bank of the Vaigai River. Built between the years 1623 and 1655, the wonderful architecture of the place is globally famous. Next, visit Alagar Koli. Alagar Koli is an exquisite temple situated in the northeast of Madurai. The temple is the rest place of Lord Vishnu and is the sacred place of this region. From there, go to visit Thirumalai Nayakar Palace. This palace was erected in 1636 in the city of Madurai by King Thirumalai Nayak. The palace depicts the perfect blend of Dravidian and Rajput styles. In the evening, enjoy light and sound show here. Day 6. On day 6, go to visit Rameshwaram from Madurai. Main places to visit are Rameshwaram Temple. Rameshwaram Temple, also known as Ramanatha Swami Temple of Tamil Nadu, is dedicated to Lord Shiva. It is one of the 12 Jyotirlinga temples of India. The temple is famous for its mind-boggling architecture. Dhanushkodi Temple and Beach. Dhanushkodi was until a few years ago a wonderful temple on the southern tip of India. However, due to a natural calamity, it got completely washed away. It is an abandoned beach now. Agnitirtham, one of the 64 sacred baths in Rameshwaram. The Agnitirtham is one of the most important tirtham and receives a large number of tourists each day. Annai Indira Gandhi Road Bridge. It is the longest bridge in southern India. It connects Rameshwaram Island to the mainland. It's constructed over the bay. It is 7 km away from Rameshwaram and is also called the Pamman Bridge. Day 7. On day 7, head back to railway station or Madurai Airport for departure. Where to stay? There are several hotels and resorts available in all the above places. A good quality mid-level hotel will charge between ₹2,000 to 3,500 per day. Total package will charge around ₹20,000 per couple, including hotel fare, food and transport.